Smarter reporting, smarter care. CMS web interface Excel file upload. Using the Excel template helps reduce the possibility of upload errors in your reporting, creating a smoother reporting experience. Here we'll cover downloading your beneficiary sample spreadsheet from the CMS web interface, understanding Excel spreadsheet template basics, simple reporting with built-in prompts and tips, drag and drop Excel uploading into the CMS web interface. Let's get going. Downloading your beneficiary sample spreadsheet. To begin reporting, navigate to the Report Data page and click the download link at the top of the page. You'll be prompted to select one of two download options, Sample with Data and Sample without Data. Sample with Data. Your Excel template will be populated with any data you've already entered into the CMS web interface, either manually, via a previous Excel upload, or via API. Sample without Data. Your Excel template will only contain CMS pre-filled data. It will be your original sample before your team inputs any data into the CMS web interface. If you haven't begun the reporting process, start with the sample without data. Now, let's go through the template itself. Understanding your streamlined Excel template. Fewer errors, faster reporting. Like all Excel spreadsheets, our template is divided into rows and columns, with each row representing a single beneficiary. Here, the blue topmost column headers delineate beneficiary demographic input fields and each of the CMS web interface measures. Pre-filled data. Light gray cells represent information that is pre-filled by CMS and is not editable by you. Measure questions. More intuitive, decisive data reporting. As you scan your Excel template, you'll notice each measure header contains the following information underneath. Beneficiary rank. This field is pre-filled by CMS. You will not be able to edit this data. If a beneficiary in your sample is ranked in a specific measure, it will have a number in the rank column. Please note, beneficiaries in your sample may not be ranked in all of the CMS web interface measures. Measure questions. If a beneficiary is ranked in the measure, the question input fields will be white or light blue. You can edit these fields. This is where you will input data. If a beneficiary is not ranked in that measure, the fields will be dark gray and you do not need to enter data. You do not need to answer questions for beneficiaries who are not ranked in the measure. Click on the Learn More link in the Measure Question column header to see additional instructions on how to answer the measure questions. Locked titles. Keep an eye on your sample. For your easy input across large samples, the measure titles, question column headers, and beneficiary ID columns are locked. Now you can scroll through the template without losing context of what you're seeing and entering. Now, on to sorting and filtering the template. Entering beneficiary data. Entering beneficiary data is straightforward. By simply clicking on the sort functionality, you can sort beneficiaries based on their rankings. Now that you have sorted your beneficiaries by rank, you can answer the measure questions. You can either input text for certain questions or, if provided, use drop-down selections to choose your answer. When entering a date into an input field, you can input any format and it will automatically change to the required format. When answering whether a patient is qualified for the measure, you will notice that if you select Yes, the next applicable input field will become active. This indicates that data is now required for the input field and you should enter the appropriate information. Any input fields that you leave blank will not be saved into the system, and any data that you've previously entered in the system will not be overwritten. For questions where you want to intentionally enter a blank to be saved into the system, select NA. Updating demographic beneficiary data. You can edit these beneficiary demographic data using the Excel template. Medical record number. You can record a number associated with your internal systems here for easy medical record location. This field is not required. Top providers 1, 2, and 3. You can record the top 3 NPIs that the beneficiary visited most often to quickly locate the beneficiary's medical records internally. these fields are also not required. Clinic ID. You can associate beneficiaries with clinics in your organization to more quickly track down their medical records internally. This field is not required. General comment. You can use this field to track any additional notes on where the beneficiary's medical record can be found internally. This field is not required. There are some beneficiary demographic data that you cannot edit through the Excel template. First name, last name, gender, date of birth. You can edit this beneficiary demographic data only using the CMS web interface manually. This process limits the difficulty of locating patients in the case of an incorrect entry. Uploading your beneficiary data. Once you've finished filling out your template, you will upload the data to the CMS web interface. You can either drag and drop your completed Excel template into the upload field in the CMS web interface, or use the browse functionality within the CMS web interface to locate your Excel file within your computer's file system. When the file is uploaded, you'll be notified that your data will be overwritten. When you are ready to proceed, click Upload. Remember, you can upload partially complete Excel files, one measure at a time, or one beneficiary at a time, if you'd like. Remember, you can also add a new column or delete any existing columns in the Excel template at your convenience. As long as you don't edit existing column headers, your upload will not be affected. A column added by you will not be saved into the system, and a deleted column will not impact any data already in the system for that measure. Remember, only the data that you have specifically entered into the Excel template will be overwritten in the system. Any input fields that are left blank will not be overwritten. Any fields for which NA is selected will be specifically overwritten with an empty value in the CMS web interface.